War. War never changes. Since the dawn of man, when tribes beat each other to death over necessities, the will to power has been the driving force of mankind. When the great fires of humanity's ambition ravaged the earth, it was not our doing. For the bloodiest chapter of human history had only begun. Britain was not spared the hellfire. And London, a monument to mankind's ambition, was returned to the state of nature. Those who emerged from the ashes did so from a network of underground bunkers known as Pindar stations. And so it was that the embers of civilization would ignite once again. Over a century later, through the military might of the Tommies, an aristocratic parliament continues to give orders. But few are still listening. In the Tower Hamlets, the fifth column rises. Training drums beat and uniforms march, all in the name of their dear leader, Eve Varney. Across the Thames, in the pastures of Richmond, a great army gathers strength. Styled on the Camelot knights of days past, they're headed once more unto the breach. For there are whispers of angels beneath this hallowed land, a curtain of illusion and intrigue, a puppeteer behind the scene. Only one thing is certain. Those who take the road to Westminster will be forever changed. Because in mankind's pursuit of power, there is no price too high, no life too valuable, and no ideal too sacred. Because war never changes.
Mind the gap. Mind the gap. Stand clear of the door, please.
Subject has been performing adequately. No spikes in visuals. Nothing unusual.
Perfectly usual.
Quite. Smythe will be pleased.
How are they in appearance?
Uncertain. Perhaps we should take a closer examination. Excellent. A rapid progress is being made. And with zero anomaly.
Of course. Now, what about their physical and mental development?
Gentlemen, I trust everything is going well.
Tremendously so. In fact, it may be our best work yet.
Good. The subject looks ready for conditioning. Within a week or so, we can wrap up phase one.
Thank you, sir. I'll set phase one on autopilot.
See that it's done.
Seems to be rousing a bit.
Not to worry. Let's put them back under.
Yeah!
got no power. The bloody thing won't budge.
You know what he's gonna do? Just a fucked clock. Winston, you have a go.
You got it, boss. Uh-huh. Yeah, no power. I can be rooted from the main network. But...
what the fuck's that on the camera? Right outside, look. It made one of the floors.
I don't give a fuck. Just get us out of here. They'll have to find their own way.
Rerouting to emergency power.
Onwards and upwards.
Where are you going? I doubt you'll make it far, someone such as yourself. You were more useful as a lab rat.
Warning. Warning. Warning.
But alas, it seems I'm not long for this world. It's a shame, really. There was so much I wanted to do. Off you go, then. Be seeing you.
Emergency decontamination in effect.
You are quite the wayfarer, aren't you? Escaping all that hubbub. With all you've been through, I'm impressed.
impressed. It seems I neglected to introduce myself. Very unprofessional of me. I'm Mr. Smythe. And you? Well, it doesn't matter who you are. Now, I'm sure you have many questions, and perhaps someday I'll answer them. But for now, wayfarer, let's not stand on parade. Since I'm all for giving one a sporting chance, I've unlocked the doors. Go. Stay safe, and remember, mind the gap.
army.
Thank you.
Bloody hell, what was that?
Sounded painful, if you ask me.
Better not be those dogs up to something. I swear if it is.
Not everything's the dogs, Johnny.
You look like shit, mate. You alright?
This one just came off the train, boss.
Quiet, the both of you. Well, well, well. If it isn't the lab rat, you made it out. You're in a right state, ain't you? Never had a crash down here before. Of course, Winston.
Here, enjoy.
Name's Gaunt. Sebastian Gaunt. And these dredges are Chill Winston and Johnny Shrapnel. But you can ignore Johnny. We're the Vagabonds.
We're the roughest, toughest, sharpest gang round these parts. Not like the dogs.
Snuff it, Johnny. Don't scare away our new acquaintance. So, who are you exactly? Only the gentry use those trains. Looks like you're a wayfarer now, like the rest of us. Yeah, it was supposed to be a supply run.
We bought the location off someone in Thameshaven. Some old construction papers.
Well then, wayfarer, seems like you got two choices. You could head down that way to the Thames folk. Ain't exactly pleasant to look at, but appearances can be deceiving. They may even know a thing or two about that lab, seeing as they sold us the location. Otherwise, you can stick it out with me and my mates. We help you out, you help us out. Let's just say that we're not the only gang sniffing around London. And we need help dealing with the competition. Obviously, we'd give you a little pick-me-up first. Ace, we could use an extra pair of hands.
Here, take this for the road. Its best days are behind it.
Look where you're going.
Right, as this seems to be a prime rabbit-in-the-headlights situation, I'll give you a rundown of who's who in old Blighty, shall I? First up, there's us. We're the Vagabonds. Used to be big names in South London till a couple of things went awry. But enough about that till later. The cunts who made things go awry are the Isle of Dogs Syndicate. There's a fucking lot of them. And they all walk around with the gentry reserves in their skyrocket, so they've got tickets to burn. They got that bees and honey dancing with the gentry. The gentry rule from their ivory towers, pissing off their pedestals from Westminster. Forget trying to get in there. Those gates are tighter than a duck's arse. Why are they so tight, you ask? Because they've got the Tommies to defend them. Powerful enough to take the peace. Too stupid to keep it. Which means the occasional toe rags crop up and have a punt at Blighty leadership. This brings me to the dress-up fashions. Take your pick. Camelot, the old Timberland Knights, Wandsworth. Or if you fancy painting it black, you've the Fifth Column Tyrants in Tower Hamlets. Next on the list, you've the twats in the periphery. Hooligans that'll smack you. Beefeaters that meet you. Jackdaws who stick a cannon up your arse. Roundels in Hackney. Well, they keep to themselves unless you've got a thing against scooters. Miller's men are the slapheads over in Islington. Neighbouring next to them are the pistols in Canada who want anarchy in the UK. All of that makes sense. So, as life dictates, you should probably stick with us. Know what I mean? The rest you can work out yourself, because I'm tired of the knocking. But yeah, if they shoot at you, they ain't your mate. Guns are more common round here these days, ever since Enfield opened its doors to all and sundry. You'll need to keep your head down. You ain't in that test tube anymore, Sunshine. Now, left, right, left, right. I think they call it walking. Is we've got a small camp across the road.
The fuck?
What? Ricky, what the fuck?
They attacked us. Took us by surprise.
How many?
Two or three. IODs.
Fucking dogs. Fuck them all.
And what the fuck were they doing here?
They were... I feel faint.
Christ, you're pathetic.
More bodies getting shite. Get
a first aid kit from Greenwich Station.
You came back.
After the IODs ambushed us, I heard them talking. There's gonna be an attack on the Swan and Mitre. The second I managed to give Gaunt that information, he left me here. The horse left me to die.
back to the Swan and Mitre, I suppose. Gaunt's gone, and he was the one with the medical know-how. Don't suppose he could fix me up. I thought you knew what you were doing. Fuck. Go to the Swan and Mitre. Give them dogs hell.
I'll see you in hell.